IVM.
If you like IVM Likes, you should definitely check out another show from the IVM network called Geek Fruit. It's a show where three geeks, Tejas, Jishnu and Dinkar, talk about everything science fiction, adventure, fantasy, movies, TV shows, everything. So quench your thirst for geek conversation every week. Episodes out every Monday and Thursday on the IVM Podcast app, the IVM website or wherever you listen to podcasts. Hello and welcome to a new episode of IVM Likes. My name is Abbas. With me in the studio are my fellow producers, Abhineet.
Hey.
And Madhuri.
Hey.
And I have Radhika.
Hello.
Who is our intern who you heard last week on IVM Likes as well. In case you're listening to this episode or this show for the first time, of course you're listening to this episode for the first time because it hasn't gone out before. But if you're listening to this show for the first time, IVM Likes is a show where IVM staffers get into the studio and give you some cool pop culture recommendations. And in the second half, we have a discussion about one particular topic regarding pop culture. And this week, that topic is pop culture that you loved or liked, but that is not loved a lot by other people. In general, it's not considered very good, but you just happen to love it. So you will own up to it in the second half. We'll get into that in a bit. But before that, we'll give you our pop culture recommendations for this week. So who wants to go first? Radhika, you want to start?
Okay. So I'm recommending today one documentary called Ahmedabad Ma Famous. It is a documentary about a very famous festival of Gujarat called Uttarayan, which is a kite, which is a kite flying festival. And this movie is, I'm not going to reveal much because the whole part is all about kite flying. But the way it has been shown, it is a very different way. This movie is directed by Hardik Mehta, who was the co-written screenplay for Trap. And also
for?
Trapped movie.
Trapped, okay.
Yeah, also worked for
Rajkumar Rao one.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
And also worked for Queen and Lutera. So this movie is captured through a boy, 11-year-old boy called Zaid. He's a Muslim boy. So he is a very passionate lover of kite. He all the time after coming from school in evening, he just flies kite. He's such a huge fan and lover of kite. Even in his dreams, he just imagine about kites and how he can just get kites from jumping from one house to another house. Through the love of kite, at the end we are the Hardik Mehta has shown Uttarayan. It has this movie almost took 2 years to cover because 1 year Hardik with his team went to figure out about this festival and about the place, and then the second year they shoot the whole movie. So, and also this movie has won a lot of awards. So this film has also received National Film Award for Best Non-Fiction Film at 63rd National Film Award 2015 and also received Best Short Documentary Award. So I have watched this movie in my college time. Very beautifully, Hardik Mehta has covered the essence of kite flying festivals. So do watch this movie. It's very sweet.
Is it in Hindi?
Yeah, yeah. It is in Hindi.
Gujarati, I guess, because it's
Gujarati, both. Okay. It's Gujarati and Hindi both. On Netflix, you will find this movie. It has subtitles also. Plus,
it's on Netflix.
Yeah, yeah, it was on Netflix. Yes. So do watch this movie. Very, very beautiful. Very, very.
What is it called?
Ahmedabad Ma Famous. I'm sure you're gonna love this boy after watching this movie. Zed.
How old is he?
11-year-old. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. And the beauty about this movie is they have captured the conversation, the life conversation that this boy is having with different people,
okay,
with his friends, with one Maulana who always objects Zaid to come at mosque and fly kite. So very real conversation. Like Zaid is talking to his friend, "Sham ko manja lene chalenge." So this is all what Hardik has covered, not at all cut any part of this movie, and has covered all very very detailed, very detailed. So do watch this movie.
How long is the movie?
30-35 minutes.
Okay,
yeah,
cool.
Yeah.
All right, so that was Radhika's recommendation. Abhineet, what do you have for us?
Okay, this time I have a movie to recommend.
Okay.
It's called The Wailing. It's a Korean film.
Okay.
The plot of the movie is like, it's a dream fantasy horror kind of a genre.
Mm-hmm.
So the main thing is, okay, I'll not give the spoilers.
Mm.
So I'll just talk
Everybody
about the no.
Okay.
Okay, there is a lot of dying in the movie.
Okay.
So the thing is, the movie revolves around a cop His family.
Okay.
Like, it revolves around his family. So what happens is the cop lives with his daughter, mother, and his wife.
Okay.
So there are
the cop's mother, the cop's wife, and the cop's daughter.
Yeah.
Okay.
So what happens is there's this sudden death revolving in the village. It's a small village on the hillside.
Okay.
So a lot of people keeps on dying, and the villagers, they relate it to a strange man who just recently shifted to their village. He's a very old man. So they think that the man, like,
is responsible
for all the deaths. So, like, he's the devil. And so what happens is, like, this cop and, like, everyone is getting this weird allergy kind of thing, and then they just die.
Okay.
Randomly again. So they just die. So what the writer or the director, what he tried to show is, like, how the villagers are trying to figure out how the father, the protagonist of the movie, because his daughter is affected by that allergy.
Okay.
So he's trying to figure out what is actually happening. So he goes to the priest or the strange guy who comes into the village. He trashes his house and he finds some weird stuff over there. And then the whole movie is like what actually happens and what actually is responsible for all these deaths.
Got it.
What is the name of the movie?
It's called The Wailing.
Wailing.
Yeah.
Okay.
And like, so how scary is the film? Like
it
is, it
is like, I watch a lot of horror movies and I'll say I'm not the person who easily gets scared.
Okay.
So I got scared watching.
Is it
this
the
movie.
Kind of film where
it's a gory kind of a film.
Okay. Does it have a lot of jump scares?
Yeah.
Oh,
it does.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. It's like, the film is in Korean.
Korean language.
And how old is the film?
It came out in 2016.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Is it available on any streaming site?
Yeah, you can watch it on Netflix.
On Netflix. Okay.
Yeah.
The Wailing.
The Wailing.
As in W-A-I-L-I-N-G.
Yeah, The Wailing.
Got it, cool. Any known names that we might have heard or seen in the film?
No. I don't know.
Okay, cool. All right, cool. So that was Abhineet's recommendation. Madhuri, what do you have?
I have an author to recommend.
Okay.
Her name is Suniti Nam Joshi.
Okay.
She calls herself a poet and fabulist.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a very different title.
Fabulist.
Instead of, yeah. So fabulist is a person who's telling you fables.
Okay.
We have all grown up listening to fables. So what she does is she's taking the same fables, but she gives it a different turn and twist so that you start questioning stuff. I'll just give you one example. She has a book called Feminist Fables. We have all heard of this tale between a monkey and a crocodile. Both of them are friends.
Mm-hmm.
Remember, we have grown up listening to it. So now in this tale, this monkey tells the crocodile, you know, you're so lucky. You have been to all the parts of the river, but I haven't been to the other side of the river. So I really want to travel. Now this monkey is she and crocodile is he. So the crocodile tells the monkey, no, you cannot travel alone. You know, there are creatures out there, there are beasts. So you shouldn't go out alone. But the monkey doesn't listen to the crocodile and ventures out. Months later, the monkey returns. This monkey is now one-eyed. She has also lost her tail. She has a broken leg. But she has come back quite happy. So the crocodile laughs at her and tells her, didn't I tell you that you shouldn't go out alone and stuff like that? She tells him, you told me that there'll be creatures out there. Why didn't you tell me? They'll look exactly like you.
Oh, wow.
And the story ends. Okay, so they're very small tales, one page. You can just read one tale at a time and it'll leave imprints on your mind.
Yeah.
She also has a book called Blue Donkey Fables. So the whole idea of having a blue donkey where everyone is white is again questioning power, race.
Mm-hmm.
So she'll use very small elements. You will think it's children's stories. But once you start reading...
with a message.
Yeah, you'll be like, oh, it's talking about me and my
mind
life.
Mind blown.
Okay.
Yeah.
What's the author's name again?
Suniti Nam Joshi.
Suniti Nam Joshi, and her books are available wherever books are
sold. Yes, Amazon, also in Zuban Books.
Okay.
It's available in Infibeam, all those sites.
Got it. So that was Madhuri's recommendation. I am recommending a music album. Does anybody on this panel listen to heavy metal music?
Mm-hmm. No.
No.
Okay, so I'm just going to do a monologue for the next 3 minutes. the album I'm recommending is called Anesthetic, and it's by a guitarist called Mark Morton.
Okay.
Have any of you heard of a band called Lamb of God?
Yeah.
Yeah, you've heard of Lamb of God? So this guy is the guitarist for Lamb of God.
Okay.
It's his solo outing. And a lot of solo guitarists recently have done this thing where they get singers of other bands. and they record an album with them. Like Slash did it with, he had Ozzy Osbourne, Chris Cornell, Maroon 5's Adam Levine, all of them. So this follows more or less the same structure as a different vocalist on every track.
Okay.
So this has one of the last recordings of Chester Bennington, actually, before he passed away.
Okay.
So there's Chester Bennington, there's the lead singer of Papa Roach, the lead singer of Arch Enemy. Even the lead singer of Lamb of God, Randy Blythe, makes an appearance on the album. The tone of the album is, even Miles Kennedy of Alter Bridge has sung a song on the album.
A lot of people.
Yeah, so if you are into hard rock or heavy metal, you will more or less like the album, because what he does is, Lamb of God is known for like very, very hard,
grunge metal kind of.
Grunge metal with guttural vocals. But here, every vocalist kind of brings their own sort of quality to each song. So like, for example, Miles Kennedy has a very powerful voice, but he belts out his songs, he sings them. So that particular song is, you know, catered to his style of singing. Chester Bennington's song is more catered to his style of singing. And the last song on the album is with Randy Blythe and the lead singer of Arch Enemy. So it's a very nice like combination of their vocal styles. So if you're someone who likes heavy metal, who likes hard rock, give it a try. It's got a lot of cool guitar riffs, and I would definitely check it out. If you're a band of any of these bands and artists that I mentioned, do check it out. I think you'll more or less like it. So that is my recommendation. The album
Abbas,
is called.
Yeah. I have a question for you.
Yeah.
When do you tune into music like this? Like, I understand where it comes from historically, but when do you listen to it? What is that mood or what time?
There is no certain time. There are times when I've listened to this this album early in the morning, and there are times when I listen to it while going back home from office. So I'm just someone who likes listening to heavy music in general. So there is no one particular time that I like to listen
to. But what impression does heavy metal have on your mind?
That's a good question. I can do a podcast on itself if we have the time. It has multiple sort of effects on me. One is that, of course, when you want to pump yourself up, when you want to like feel alive about yourself, I listen to heavy metal. Then it also, if you see the lyrical themes of metal and the fact that it's not designed to make you feel pretty. It's not the kind of music that is put together to make you feel, I won't say feel good about yourself, but it's not supposed to give you positive vibes in the cliche positive, like advertising is made to feel you good about yourself or really. I think heavy metal is more like it makes me feel like this kind of sound or this kind of mood is not very happy, but it still makes you feel like it's okay to be who you are. It's okay if you're not feeling great, because these guys who are singing are also not probably feeling great about themselves, but they're expressing it. They're expressing their agony in different ways.
Does it have anything to do with anger? Like your anger?
That, I think it's a cliche. A lot of people. It is to do with anger, yes, but it's not about, it's about being okay with your anger. If you're feeling angry, and if you listen to heavy metal and you're okay with that, I'd rather prefer that than you be angry and go beat someone else while listening to Katy Perry or something. I'm like, then you're not really, you know, you're doing bad things with your anger. Everybody feels angry, everybody has angst. So I think music like this helps me be okay with that. I'm like, oh.
Have you been to live shows?
I have, yes. I went to the Iron Maiden show in Bangalore, which had around 40,000 people in Bangalore. So that was great. I've been when I was in Bangalore before I moved to Bombay. Bangalore has a very active metal scene. There's still got a lot of shows. Yeah. And that's the thing. I mean, if you go to a heavy metal show, these people who seem very aggressive and angry in the show, after they come out, they're fine. It's not like they're gonna beat them. They're beating each other up. So I think
it's all about what you stand for. When they're singing it, maybe they're standing for something, some ideology, and it comes out.
Yes. It's kind of like your author. Anyway, so the album is called Anesthesia. The guitarist's name is Mark Morton.
When did this come out?
This came out actually in February this year.
Yeah. Okay.
So he's been making this album for a really long time, but because it involved so many people in the studio, it took him quite a while to make it, but it's finally out. So check it out. So that was my recommendation. Before we move on to the second half, let's just recap the recommendations again. Radhika, you recommended?
My recommendation was Ahmedabad, My Famous, a documentary.
Abhineet?
I recommended a Korean movie called The Wailing.
Madhuri?
I recommended Suniti Namjoshi's books, Feminist Fables and Blue Donkey Fables.
And I recommended an album called Anesthetic. As Abhineet pointed out, it's not Anesthesia. It's called Anesthetic and it's by Mark Morton. So check it out. We'll take a break. And when we come back, we will confess our love for things that are not very well loved. We'll see you on the other side of this break.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to another awesome week on the IVM Podcast Network. If you're not following us on social media, please make sure that you do. We're IVM Podcast on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. So if you guys haven't been checking our Instagram, you should take a look at the audiograms. We're giving you excerpts from different shows. This is available both on our stories and on our feed. Also, we put these audiograms up on Facebook and Twitter as well. So, I mean, like, do kind of keep an eye out for them. You kind of enjoy them, I think. On Cyrus Says, Cyrus is joined by Abuzar Akhtar, who talks about his difficult journey from a businessman in Dubai to a playback singer in Bollywood. Film producer and close friend of mine, Koki Gulati, also joins in to talk about his discovery of Abuzar. You should also check out episode 350 of Cyrus Says, which was an AMA special. It featured a roundtable of other IVM hosts like Varun Dugirala of Advertising is Dead, Naren Chinoy from Simplified, Dinkar Dwivedi from Geek Fruit, and, of course, me and Abbas. Anirudh Kanishetty is back with season 2 of Echoes of India from the 27th of March. On the first episode of the season, Anirudh is going to start from where he left off, the rise of the Gupta Empire. New episodes are out every Wednesday. On Puliya Bazi, Pranay and Saurabh talk to Disha Malik and Kavita Devi, who run Khabar Lahariya, a woman-run rural media network in UP. On Noyer Kanun, Ambar Rana is joined by wife and model Hasleen Kaur to talk about the safety of women in the entertainment industry. On Football Twaddle, Saru and Kanav talk about last week's FA Cup and EPL action as the race for the title and top 4 heats up. On Thalle Harate last week, Uday Kumar joins hosts Pawan and Ganesh to discuss the oldest inscription stone in Bengaluru, which opens the historical understanding of the city. On the Sponge podcast, Ambi Parmeshwaran talks about the time when he was invited to present tax collection and communication strategies. And with that, let's continue on with your show.
And we're back after the break. So we had this idea in office that everybody has their tastes and we should all be proud and we should all stand up for the tastes we have. So we're going to talk about films and TV shows and books and music that we like, but they're not well-loved generally. Especially in today's times, you come under a lot of peer pressure to like the things everybody likes and not like the things that everybody doesn't like. But we're going to break that myth today. So who wants to go? I think Radhika has a list of things.
I think I should say in
you should
the
want
end.
To save it? Okay,
no, no.
Cool.
In the end, because such bizarre and I have such bizarre and strange names that after listening to my list, people will not go with me for a movie or something. They'll never take me out. So
okay.
I should keep.
So we'll save that to the end. I'll start. I love the film Savariya, starring Ranveer Kapoor.
I love
Kapoor.
It too, somehow. Yeah.
What about Abhineet? Have you seen Savariya?
I could not.
You know, I think half
I like the songs.
Okay. But you couldn't stand the movie?
No.
But I think many people did not watch it because of the way it went around.
Yeah.
Like, many people started saying bad things. And so, even if you want to watch it, you just dropped the idea.
No, I tried around. Watching it. Like, I started it. But I could not.
Radhika, did you like Savariya?
I should not say anything.
I think it's on our list too.
Because after this stick to my list, Savariya is much, much, much
okay,
better.
I can see where this
okay,
is
what
going.
About you guys? Abhineet, Madhuri?
Okay, I'll say like, not
yeah,
recommend.
You can recommend. You can recommend, yes.
I'll talk about this movie called Hamari Adhuri Kahani.
Okay.
So this movie, like, I like this movie pretty much because like, it's a pretty depressing movie.
Okay. So, of course.
I think on IVM Likes, there's going to be one genre called Abhineet genre. If all your listeners are going to associate
depressing.
It certain
if you are depressed.
Yeah, sad face Abhineet.
Sad.
So what's who's in the movie and what's it about? I don't remember.
Imran Hashmi and Vidya Balan are in this movie.
Okay.
Like the movie, even Rajkumar Rao is in the movie.
Okay.
So what the movie is about is like Vidya Balan is a single parent, like in a way, because Rajkumar Rao goes like he vanishes somehow. Like so, Vidya Balan is just a single parent. So she's a florist. And she goes to this hotel. She works in this hotel, which is owned by Imran Hashmi.
Okay.
So then the things escalate.
Things happen.
Yeah. Okay. Things happen.
But is it one of those movies that you think did not get as much acclaim as it should have, or was it like properly given bad reviews, but you think no, it's really good?
The second one.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. It wasn't that good. I've seen the movie.
But I really liked it.
Even I liked
for Radhika, it should be. Is there anything you
don't like? Yeah. Okay, I really like the songs.
Yeah, songs are pretty good. Even the movie was pretty good. I liked the movie. And Imran Hashmi dies, guys.
Wow. Okay.
Okay. Let's say that. The spoiler.
Is that why you like it? Yeah. He died. I really like that film. Madhuri, what about you?
I have a very recent film that I liked. Not liked a lot. एक लड़की को देखा तो ऐसा लगा लाइक देयर रियली बैड रिव्यूज अबाउट इट एंड नॉट मेनी पीपल वेंट टू सी दैट आफ्टर द रिव्यूज बट आई लाइक्ड इट फॉर राजकुमार राव लाइक हिज पंच लाइंस एंड हिज एंटरटेनमेंट मेक्स इट अ कंप्लीट पैकेज ऑल्सो अनिल कपूर्स एक्टिंग सो इट डजंट टॉक अबाउट होमोसेक्सुअलिटी द वे इट शुड एंड द गर्ल रिमेन्स हिडन हर गर्लफ्रेंड रिमेन्स हिडन थ्रू आउट द स्टोरी विच आर रियली बैड एलिमेंट्स बट ओवरऑल आई एंजॉयड द फिल्म ऑल द साउंड ट्रैक्स एंड ऑल इट्स लाइक गिल्टी प्लेजर आई डिडंट वॉन्ट टू एंजॉय बिकॉज आई हैव सीन अदर मूवीज They talk about homosexuality in very critical ways with critical lens. So that way, it does no justice to it. Okay. But I enjoyed it.
Okay.
Fair enough.
Okay, ek-ek karke Radhika. give us a hint.
Okay, I'll take the names and I'll...
Sure. Okay, before you tell us the names, are you someone who generally likes stuff? Like, is there very few things that you don't like?
So, no, aisa nahi hai.
Okay.
Just
go ahead and tell us the names.
Abhineet knows, right?
My list.
Yeah. So I have this list, which I don't know, but I like those movies.
Okay.
Starting with Prince.
Prince.
Okay.
The one with Vivek Oberoi.
Oh no.
Okay.
That hurts.
Why?
Second movie is Players.
The Abbas Mastan classic players, if you starring Abhineet and Sonam Kapoor,
Abhishek Bachchan,
in which they hack something.
Yeah. So I like that hacking thing.
Okay.
Okay.
There was Neel Nitin Mukesh as well.
All the parts of Hate Story.
Ooh, are we still doing this?
Yeah, it's a good question, Abhineet.
Okay,
tell us what was it about Hate Story that you liked?
First was that revenge story, Siddharth. When I remember,
has anyone else seen even one of the Hate Stories?
No.
You've seen which one?
It's
not worth remembering.
No.
So all the parts of Hate Story has some kind of suspense that
the moment I think of Hate Story, only one thing comes in my mind.
No, what? It's
which is
sex.
No, that's how they make it. Yeah. Even the poster,
that's why I'm trying to get it. Like you're saying, there's something.
So that's
more
why I watch
it.
These movies because
they talk about sex.
No,
because you want to know if there's something beyond.
Yeah.
That.
So okay. Through songs, what they try to do, all sexual things, all closeness and everything, but it's actually not. Only in some part, like only in songs.
Sex is only in the songs. Abhineet. Yeah. The rest of the film is a masterpiece.
I really doubt that.
So I like the second one. It was like, I think, starring Zareen Khan and Sharman Joshi.
Oh, I watched
you saw that one.
It was nice. Like
the Karan.
Yeah, it was a revenge story that Karan takes that revenge for his friend. Sharman Joshi and Zareen was in... I don't remember the story.
That's the reason.
What? So there's more list. I like Begum Jaan. I don't know why.
No, Begum Jaan was really critically
Begum
well
Jaan
received.
Is the one with Vidya Balan.
Yes.
Ah, okay. Two Vidya Balan appearances on this episode.
And also, not to say, but I like Hamshakals also.
Okay.
What is Hamshakals?
It was this comedy film.
Yeah.
There were three Ram Kapoor, three Saif Ali Khan.
Oh my! I probably erased it from my memory.
That.
Hey, have you seen that film Bhagam Bhag?
Yeah,
it's nice. I
liked
it.
Yeah.
But Hamshakal, seriously.
Not love, but just for, and also one more. Dilwale.
Oh man.
I watched it for 10 minutes and now, I switched off my TV.
Now people are going to not take your recommendation from the first half. They're like, no, screw this.
No. She likes it. It's a disclaimer. No. I do watch good content also.
Don't tell me you like Himmat Wala as well.
No. But I really like that song.
Okay. From Himmat Wala?
Yeah, Tamanna and Ajay.
I'm not talking to her again.
I have done stage performance on that song.
Okay.
Let that sink in.
So these were my list. Should I just repeat?
What's your rush? You like that film, didn't you? Be honest. You liked What's Your Rush?
Actually,
Love Story 2015?
No. I actually watched because for my zodiac sign, so I watched the whole movie.
I think I like
that. Wow,
the
okay. What about Mohenjo-daro?
No. How about Aitle Mushkil?
This was Ranbir Kapoor,
yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Who else was in that film?
Anushka Sharma.
There was Fawad Khan.
Yeah.
Oh, that was a good film.
Yeah, that was a good film. I liked that.
But it wasn't so well received.
Yeah, but it was good.
It was, I also
I liked it.
Yeah.
Oh, Aidila Mushkil, the Karan Johar film.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. I liked the first half. I think in the second half, they really bossed it up. Mm-hmm. Which I think is the case with most of Karan Johar's films. Mm-hmm. I like the first half of Kabhi Alvida Na Kehna also.
Yes.
And exactly. The second half is just.
I agree.
Yeah. Radhika's like, no. Sahid, both halves are amazing.
I like Kabhi Alvida Na Kehna. So, whenever I sit sad or depressed, so I watch
Kabhi Alvida Na Kehna. Dude, doesn't that depress you even more?
But I like.
Oh, okay. I guess it's the same how I listen to heavy metal to feel good about Radhika.
I think I should switch to Abbas because I have very bad names. People were not going to listen to me also.
Even I'm not listening to you.
But did you guys know even Andaz Apna Apna when it released did not get some good reviews? Okay.
But the movie was good.
Movie was good, yeah.
Guys, what about Krish? Krish 2.
The first
Krish
one was 3,
you
good.
Mean.
I would say
Koi Mil Gaya was a far superior film.
It was amazing.
I mean, Koi Mil Gaya is also copied, but they at least put more Indian elements in Koi Mil Gaya than Krish being like, just like, let's just put it.
What was that movie? Sheeta Ki Jawani.
Not Om Shanti Om.
Tees Maar. I like that movie.
Oh my god. I think we should rap. Like, I feel like the more further
guys,
we
that's
go.
That's a rap.
We should not let her speak now.
Tees Maar.
Okay, name one movie that you didn't like.
And now we are talking.
Yeah.
One movie that you like, this is a bad film.
Pataka.
Really?
What? I didn't like Pataka.
You didn't like, oh my god, Radhika's choices are all like a Vishal Bhardwaj film is not good, but a Farah Khan film is up there. Pataka. No, that's okay, that's totally fine. At least she's standing up to her.
She's completely like my mom. Like, the movies which my mom likes, I never watch them.
Okay. Like, name one.
I like erase all those films. Okay. I need to think hard.
Okay, I didn't do this last.
Sure.
Tiger Zinda Hai.
The
first one.
Both.
The first one I liked. I haven't seen the second one.
The first one was good. Second was Tiger Zinda Hai.
Nice.
Okay. Another film that didn't get good, most people don't like, is Saath Khoon Maaf. I liked it.
I actually liked it.
No. Doesn't qualify, guys.
No.
I watched it quite later, but I was wondering why would she kill this husband now? Because towards the very end, they would find out some
That's
flaw.
One way to watch the film and like it.
Okay, there's this movie which everyone liked, but I did not like.
Which is?
Dangal.
You did not like. Why? Because see, so I'm not the only one.
No.
Okay, I would want to know.
I have an explanation. Because the movie is basically about two wrestlers, female wrestlers, right? Mm. They do take the names as well.
Mm.
But I feel that in the movie, they are overshadowed by Amir Khan.
Amir Khan?
Yeah. Because all their decisions, all everything is based on Aamir Khan. That's what I feel.
But did you watch the ending?
Yeah, I did.
So in that's what they have shown. Like till the end, it's him who's taking the decisions. But at the end, the daughter takes over when he isn't around, and she finally learns to take her own decisions.
But that's because she's living in a different environment, right? Geeta, you're talking about Geeta, right?
Yeah.
Babita, she lives with the father, with Aamir Khan, right? But she's not allowed to think or not allowed to take her own decisions, because that's what I felt about the movie.
I think they did not show much about the second sister going to another level.
Yeah.
So if they had covered that, maybe it would have
been different. The main part of main motive of the film was to showcase Geeta and Babita, right?
Yeah.
Their journey, how.
Yeah. But they have just shown how Aamir Khan is helping Geeta in reaching to the international Olympic level.
How from Aamir Khan point of view, something like that.
Okay.
You're listening to the Dangal podcast. So you didn't like the film. You liked the
film. I liked the film.
Radhika,
I liked.
You also liked the film. I haven't seen the film, so I can't comment on it.
I totally agree to what he says.
Okay.
But there's this last moment where she actually takes her own decision. The movie ends on that.
Yeah.
Aamir Khan isn't around, and she has to take a call.
Okay.
And she does that.
Okay.
Yeah. So it's like now she's coming out and. Doing it on her own.
Cool.
So there was one movie which I couldn't understand what they're trying to say. Like in first watch when I watched, Dil Dhadakne Do.
Oh, you didn't like it?
Actually, I couldn't get what they were trying to say. But when I watched it twice and thrice, then I got it. Okay, this is about family, making Priyanka Chopra married to someone just because of the some business merger. But starting when I watched with my mother, we were like blank. What is, why it is going in such fast pace.
Okay.
So that movie I didn't like.
Got it.
I like that.
I like Dil Dhadakne Do.
I was okay with it. Yeah, I thought that the previous films that Zoya Akhtar made were much better. I thought Zindagi Na Milegi Dobara was a far superior film than Dil Dhadakne Do. But it was okay. I didn't dislike the film. What else? Do you have any other films?
What about books? Like, are there any books that you have liked but people around you haven't?
I don't read.
I'm not.
I do, but he's confessed.
So, when I was in class 11, 12, I used to read Chetan Bhagat, of course.
I thought she'll say Adi Sharma.
What?
Adi Sharma.
No. So,
we have all beginning.
But when I saw my friends reading some other author's books, I used to feel bad that I am reading Chetan Bhagat.
I was just going to come to that. So what's the general consensus about Chetan Bhagat in this room? You like his books, dislike his books?
Dislike his books now.
Like his books, dislike his books?
I have only watched movie.
Oh, you haven't read his books?
No.
Dislike. Now dislike. Yeah.
Okay.
No, I have read every book. Now I dislike. I like The Revolution 2020.
That's a compilation of his. Oh, no. Revolution 2020.
2020.
Okay,
that was pretty different.
Fourth or fifth book.
Yeah.
So I think his first book, 5 Point Someone and Two States. Are, I think, genuinely well written books. I think when he writes from his own life experiences, he writes well. I think 5 Point Someone is genuinely like a well-written campus novel about campus life in India, and it was made into Three Idiots.
Yeah.
And I think that's genuine. That's the one book of his, I think, that he's written well. Two States also is well written, though I think in that he makes himself look like a hero a little too much.
Is it same as the movie, the book?
I haven't seen
which one is Three Idiots?
Two States.
Which one is Three Idiots?
Three Idiots is 5 Point Someone.
And which one is Kai Poche?
Kai Poche is Three Mistakes of My Life, but I think Kai Poche is actually a better film than
better
the book.
Film. Yeah, yeah.
So yeah, I mean, okay. I get it that I don't really think very highly of him as a person, because I think he keeps switching loyalties and he makes some really stupid statements also. But I think as a writer, he's written two books which are really good. The rest of them are I haven't read some of his recent ones, but I think the rest of them more or less
okay.
What about Durjoy Dutta?
I haven't read Durjoy Dutta, so I can't comment.
No,
I just heard songs.
Yeah.
Of Durjoy Dutta?
No, not Durjoy Dutta.
Movie.
No, songs referring to Durjoy Dutta. Yeah.
Okay. So he's essentially our version of Mills and Bones.
Yeah.
The Indian version of
Any singers? Any singers other than like
singers?
Yeah. Song that you like
that others don't.
Yeah.
Baba Sehgal. I genuinely think Baba Sehgal is a talented guy.
Yeah.
He knows how to sell himself, and he's made this image about himself on purpose.
Yeah.
Everybody thinks he's an idiot, he's a fool, but I think he's really talented.
Have you heard his recent songs?
I've heard Adrak Wali Chai and I love it.
I can list out a number of songs. Going to
now
the
you've
gym.
Also joined Radhika. He's got recommendation. So what are your favorite Baba Sehgal songs?
Aloo Ka Paratha.
Oh, that's a good one. Yeah.
Are there songs named like this?
Yeah.
Madhuri, you should check this
chicken
out.
Fried
yeah.
rice.
Okay. I wanted to talk about a book. So yeah. we had this 700 page book called Kakol. Because it was 700
yeah,
page yeah, because it was 700 page. We had a class of 180 kids and nobody read the book except two of us who were making the presentations in the class.
One of them was you?
Yeah.
But did you like the film?
I loved the book. Yeah, I loved that book. Okay. One, it's shown from Meera's husband's point of view.
Right.
He's cuckolded in this book.
Yeah. Okay.
So usually we really rever this figure called Meera Bai, and we look at her love as something which is bhakti. Mm. So here this book tries to talk about sexuality via bhakti, and it tells you how the husband was cuckolded. So different version of a story. So I really liked it.
But I think in books there is more of an acceptance. Like you'll find authors or books which are not really critically acclaimed, they'll still have a large following, whereas I think in book in films and music you're looked down upon more if you like something that's not very interesting. Cool. Any last confessions, Radhika, before we wrap up? Come on, one more film.
Not film.
Okay.
But
singer.
So this is not at all social media or Instagram.
Okay.
So this me and my roommate always does when we are in a lot of bombarded with a lot of assignments and we have to make ourselves a little happy, or so we watch some idiotic content. We want some kuch to information nahi chahiye.
You genuinely like Prince, so I want to know what is your version of idiotic content.
So on Instagram we always go and watch Rakhi Sawant and Deepak Kalal, and not only
Deepak
just
Kalal. Seriously.
And not just to get rid of all the assignments and not only just their posts, we go and read their comments.
that's actually strange.
Such strange and idiotic comments that people post. So we go, we read, and we just chit chat. Oh, look at this boy commenting on Rakhi face, lips, or whatever.
It's like dumbness raised to power 100.
But
that's okay. I guess we should all just we should stand for what we like, regardless. Radhika today stood up for the three hate stories, so
yes.
Take inspiration from that and stand up for what you like, regardless of whether anyone else likes it or not. Cool. That was our episode for this week. If you have any confessions, do write into us using the hashtag IVMLikes, and do give us recommendations and suggestions of what you want us to talk about. You can follow us on social media. We are IVM Podcasts on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook, at IVM Podcasts on all three. You can follow us personally as well. My Twitter handle is at Abbas Momin. Madhuri, where can one follow you?
My Twitter handle is at Advani Madhuri.
Radhika, where can one follow you?
Please do follow me. I do have very good
Or you can find her on Rakhi Sawant's Instagram wall.
I post very good photos, street photos. So do follow the Tranquil Soul Instagram.
And you guys can reach me on Instagram at Abhineet Mandal, ABHINEET.
What do you post?
There's nothing particular. you just follow me.
Randomly.
I would like to add my Insta handle. It's called Mad Ad, and I post 1 minute short stories on my handle. So
you should
do check them out.
Follow her.
Oh,
and,
wow. And inside recommendation. Nice. I will try and watch some of the films that you say are not as
go,
bad.
Go for Hamshakal. Go for
no,
it.
Go for Dilwale.
Oh my god, I'm regretting this already. Alright, we'll catch you next week on another episode of IVM Likes. Till then, bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Hi listeners, we at Aditya Birla Sun Life Mutual Fund have come up with a special podcast series called MF 101 in collaboration with Bloomberg Quint. MF 101 is an informative series that will help you understand the recipe behind mutual fund investments. And what's more, it's coming from the chefs of the mutual fund buffet table, from the very own fund managers and analysts who are the manufacturers of the funds that help you realize your investment goals. New episodes out every Monday. You can listen to the show on the IVM Podcast app or wherever you get your podcasts.
advertising is dead. Yep, you heard me right. Advertising is dead. We're all in the content business now. Let's not call it news, TV, radio, etc., etc. It's all content, and we're in the middle of this weirdly exciting phase where all the borders and lines that have been drawn over decades has been swept away by this lovely thing called the internet. We're a show where we don't dwell on just the stuff that is now, but rather the wider stuff about advertising, media, content, and the whole goddamn circus surrounding it. Tune in every Tuesday for our weekly unboxing of the mystery box we used to call advertising. I'm Varun Dugirala, co-founder and content chief at The Glitch, and this is my new podcast, Advertising is Dead.